Little Ada was born in December 1815 in London. Her father, Lord Byron, was a widely acclaimed poet, but he also liked to play the field. Ada's mother couldn't stand her husband's pastimes, which had gone public and humiliated her. She ran away with her daughter when she was only 1 month old. Ada never saw her father again. Lady Byron, Ada's mother, worked very hard to educate her daughter, especially in sciences. She wanted Ada to grow into a rational and cultured adult, not so that she could navigate a male-dominated field, but rather to impede her naturally fertile imagination so that she would pick a better husband than her mother had. Ada's education was intensive, but she never got rid of her imagination. On the contrary, she used it to better understand the concepts she would learn. One day, she discovered Mr. Jacquard's semi-automatic loom. She was fascinated by it. Mr. Jacquard had revolutionized the textile industry. His machine was 24 times faster than previous looms. It could even weave patterns that were so cumbersome to realize by hand. What fascinated her most was that the machine used punch cards. The way it worked was using a layer of needles tied to some thread. When a card would reach it, only the needles that faced a hole would come down and weave thread into the fabric. Ada didn't care much about fabric, but she thought that the punch cards were genius. She was already picturing all that could be done with them. When she was 17, her mother sent her to a lot of high society parties so that she could find a husband. She was old enough for it. But really, Ada wanted to meet the scientists of her time. She was so eager to learn from them. At one of those parties, she met a 42-year-old man named Charles Babbage. He was the archetype of the mad scientist, an eccentric man with an enthusiasm that never wavered. He had invented the difference engine, a sort of mechanical calculator specialized in polynomials. Babbage was fascinated by Jacquard's loom as well, and he wanted to use punch cards to create a new machine, the Analytical Engine, which is the ancestor of our computers. Nobody could have foreseen it at the time, but his machine was a brilliant invention. His and Ada's shared passions for punch cards and mathematics led them to become true friends. At 19 years old, Ada met William Lovelace. It wasn't love at first sight, but he was okay and he accepted that she was smarter than he was. They got married and had 3 children. From then on, Ada Byron would be known as Ada Lovelace. Once she was done fulfilling her maternal obligations, she did all she could to get back to what she truly loved, mathematics. She got a tutor, Augustus de Morgan, in order to deepen her understanding of mathematics. She would never know it, but Augustus wasn't too keen to teach her at first because the foundations of mathematics and sciences were not meant for women to learn. Although this was a widely shared opinion at the time, Ada's mother and husband managed to convince him to make an exception and teach her anyway. Menabrea, an Italian mathematician, published an article about the analytical engine that Charles Babbage was trying to make. Ada decided to translate it to English and add extra notes so that Babbage's work would be known in England. She also hoped that this might help her warm her way into the intellectual circle she loved and free her from the housewife life. Ada thought that the notes she added helped better explain how the analytical engine worked. They would take the reader through it, step by step. Well, a reader that knew quite a lot about mathematics anyway. She worked on that manuscript relentlessly. She anticipated the future possibilities for this type of engine. She even thought that it would allow for music to be recorded and played once again. Nowadays, it seems that her vision and understanding of the engine exceeded even that of Babbage. He had become the technician of his engine and she the brains behind it. Babbage suggested she would sign the manuscript with her whole name. She hadn't thought about it. She thought it was a very bold idea, but accepted to sign it with her initials, hoping to be read and judged for her work, free from judgment regarding her gender. That didn't really work. Her manuscript didn't incite much interest at all. She wasn't given much credit, even though the math was known to be good. The whole theory she developed never got tested with Babbage's engine. It was too costly and required the making of 20,000 gears. It was too early then for the scale of engineering. Ada fell sick. Her illness lasted for years. The only medicine that managed to relieve her pain was opium. She had uterus cancer that got the best of her at 36 years old. Per her request, she was buried next to her father. They were separated during life, but will spend eternity together. Future inventions would be more grateful for Ada's work. One of her notes, the G note, ended up being the ancestor of a computer program, what makes her the first programmer ever.
Hello guys, thank you for watching. Also a big thank you to Vivian right here. She did all the research and the voiceover for this video. Can you tell us about your channel?
Yes, my channel is called Syllabus and we talk about science, we make experiments and we are trying to have fun doing it.
The channel is in French, but it is very easy to understand. Everything is subtitled.
So come check it out and maybe you'll like it.